I was seated at a wine dinner, judges dinner one evening, and one of the judges said, I'm going to show you the best sweet wine in the world. So we tasted the wine, thinking it would be French. It wasn't. It was marvellous. It was complex. It was original. And he said, this is from Robert Fumara from Lilly Pilly in the Riverina at Leeton. And I knew Robert, and it immediately made sense to me. I thought, yep, I can go with this. But it was interesting that it took another winemaker from another company to bring it to my mind yet again about the quality of these wines. Lilly Pilly often found in New South Wales restaurants because his style of Botrytis wine is both more complex, less sweet, and less oaked than the industry standard. He has a number of different tools at his disposal. Vineyard. Rather than Semillon, which is the Riverina standby, he uses Riesling, Muscat, Sauvignon Blanc, and Gewürztraminer, as well as Semillon. So his five varieties give him a much wider palette between the non-aromatic and aromatic whites. Not every variety gets Botrytis every year. So you're going to wind up with the blend that Robert makes varying dramatically according to the season. There have even been years when he's made no wine. He will then ferment the most Botrytis affected and make his blend up of the different varieties of each year. So each wine very faithfully mirrors the Botrytis influence on those varieties on that year. So each wine is very much very unique. He doesn't look for high alcohol, 11% would be ideal for him, nor does he look for super rich. There is a class of Australian Botrytis Semillon which can be 220 grams per litre of residual sugar. In context, Sauternes 120 grams, 140. Robert's wines try for that somewhere between 120 and 180 grams, but obviously it's in the lap of the year, and each year will give him quite a different style. So less sweet, less oaky, more complex, using aromatic varieties. The 2002 is the benchmark for all modern Australian Botrytis wines, but each year he produces a wine which has to be considered within the light of, is this great internationally? Because it's certainly great in Australia.